Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Snehlata Reddy, Assistant Professor of Physics, Pingley Government College for Women, Warangal. Today, we are going to deal with Gauss law in electrostatics. Before going to deal with the Gauss law in electrostatics, let me first explain how to calculate electric flux. Electric flux. For a given surface immersed in a uniform electric field. Yesterday we discussed that electric flux is nothing but the number of lines of force through any given surface. Per unit area of that surface is defined as electric flux. That we denoted it by phi E. This is electric flux. Now, how to calculate the value of this electric flux when a surface is immersed in an electric field of strength E? So here in the picture, I'm showing a cylinder of radius R, and it is immersed in electric field of intensity E. And see here you could be able to see three surfaces for this cylinder: DS1, DS2 and DS3. Extreme left end curved surface, circular surface here seen is, let that be DS1, and extreme right end of the cylinder is DS3, and the curved surface seen over there is DS2. Now this is the surface area I am taking for that three surfaces of the given cylinder immersed in an electric field. Now see, the surface DS1 is acting in opposite direction to that of electric field E at that point. So at point of the surface DS1, the electric field is acting towards right and the surface direction is towards left end. Now both the two vectors are acting on a line opposite to each other. Hence the angle between those two vectors is 180. Yesterday we dealt that the electric flux is phi E is equal to integral E dot ds and E ds cos theta. Here theta is 180 degrees and hence its cos 180 is minus 1. Therefore, the value of the electric flux at the left end surface of the cylinder shown in the figure immersed in electric field is minus Es. Now, in the same way, if you consider the curved surface of the cylinder, the surface ds, elemental surface, I am taking it as ds2 in the figure. So the surface is acting exactly perpendicular to the electric field intensity direction. Hence, see, the angle between those two vectors is 90. Then an integral of E dot ds2 becomes 0 because E ds2 cos 90 is 0, and hence the electric flux through the curved surface of the cylinder is 0. Now if you come to the extreme right end of the cylinder, there the surface is denoted by ds3, and the surface and the electric field intensity both are acting in the same direction, and hence the angle between them is 0. Therefore, there the integration of E dot ds3 is simply Es cos 0 and it is Es. So the total electric flux through the cylinder for the given cylinder immersed in this uniform electric field of intensity E is found to be 0. So here I can give you an information that whenever the electric flux at the point of entering into the surface, that is inward normal electric flux remains to be always negative, whereas outward normal remains to be positive. The electric flux remains to be positive. So this you have to remember. So this is useful in the further topics like Gauss law, we see, and applications of Gauss law. How to calculate the electric flux is important. So this here you have to remember to calculation of the electric flux in this way. Now let me come to the next topic, Gauss law. So here Gauss law, what is Gauss law? Before going to know about Gauss law, let me first remember you Coulomb's law. What is Coulomb's law? Coulomb's law is nothing but from Coulomb's law, we can be able to find the value of electric field intensity when the charge is given. We can be able to find the value of electric field intensity with the help of Coulomb's law. But in converse, Gauss law enables us to determine the value of the charge when the electric field is given. If E is given, you can find the value of Q. Whereas in case of Coulomb's law, if you know the charge, it sets up electric field and you can find out the value of electric field. So exact converse of that is Gauss law. So what is the statement for the Gauss law? What does Gauss law states? Let me see. Gauss law states that the total normal electric flux phi E over a closed surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge Q enclosed within the surface. Okay, so what does the Gauss law states? Whatever be the total electric flux enclosed within a closed surface, the electric flux is always 1 by epsilon naught times, 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed within the surface. For example, if the total charge enclosed in the surface is Q, then the total electric flux can be calculated by the help of Gauss law, that states that it is 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by the surface. This is Gauss law. Mathematically, we can show Gauss law, we can state Gauss law mathematically from the equation shown in this slide. So that is electric flux phi E is equal to, we know that it is integral E dot ds, so it is integral, it is a scalar product, so it is integral of E ds cos theta, and that is 1 by epsilon naught times Q. Here epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space. We already discussed what is permittivity. Permittivity is the property of that medium which governs the electric lines of force in that field, right? So next let us look into the proof of this Gauss law. For this we have to choose a closed surface, right, of area S, say S, okay, and within that surface I am considering a point O. At that point a charge Q is supposed to be placed, right? A closed surface is considered, and in that surface a point O is considered. At that point a charge Q is taken, and let me assume a point P, a small infinitesimal area ds at point P here, right? So that is at a distance of r. That is at a distance of r. So the point P is shown in the figure in the small elemental area which is shown at the boundary of that figure C. So at the boundary of the figure we have taken a small elemental area ds. At that area I have considered a point P, and that point P is at a distance of r from the point O, right? And here the surface ds is the vector ds is acting at an angle theta to the electric field intensity E, right? So that is ds is the direction of the normal, and that is acting at an angle of theta with the electric field intensity. Now how to calculate the electric flux? And here d omega is the solid angle, that is the angle subtended at point O, right? That is the angle subtended at point O, that is solid angle over there. And see here the electric flux d phi e, which is outwards. See, the electric flux is outwards from the surface. I'll speak about the inward flux in the next case, where here this next case where the charge is outside, and this particular case is where the charge is kept inside the closed surface. Here in case of proving the Gauss law, we consider two cases. One is when the charge is placed inside the surface. Now here I am considering case where the charge is placed inside the closed surface. Now in the next case I will deal with the charge, when the charge is, I will calculate the value of electric flux when the charge is outside the surface. This is the case where the charge is inside the surface, right? So if it is inside the surface, that is electrically outward normal. Outwards, the electric flux is an outward normal. So the electric flux d phi e outwards through the area ds. First I would like to calculate the electric flux for the small elemental area ds, right? So that I assumed it as d phi e, and I will integrate it and find out the electric flux for the total surface area. So the electric flux d phi e outwards through the area ds is given by d phi e is equal to e dot ds. This we know. So that is equal to e ds cos theta, and that is, let it be equation number 1. Here theta is the angle between e and ds. I have mentioned it earlier. And electric field intensity E at a point P at distance r, which is at a distance r from a point charge Q, is given by E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square, right? We know it very well. The electric field intensity is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square. We dealt it earlier, right? Next, let this be equation number 2. Now from equations 1 and 2, EdS cos theta and E. So I am substituting the value of E, the electric field intensity 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square, or Q by 4 pi epsilon naught r square, at d phi e is equal to e value is said to be this one, and ds cos theta. So I have rearranged the terms, and like q by 4 pi epsilon naught into ds cos theta by r square, but ds cos theta by r square is a solid angle subtended by ds at O. So the small elemental area we consider ds, that subtends an angle of omega at d omega at point O, where we have assumed the in the closed surface. So that is the solid angle. So d phi e is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught d omega. This is d omega. D is cos theta by r square. It is a mathematical expression. The solid angle is given by d omega. So the total flux phi e over the entire surface now is given by phi e is equal to, just now we have discussed, if d phi e is for the small elemental area, then phi e is the electric flux for the entire closed surface. So phi e is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught integral d omega. Here integration of d omega is nothing but it is again omega. So this is solid angle subtended by whole surface. If you integrate it, you will get for whole. So for whole surface at point O, we get the value of integration of d omega is omega, and that is equal to 4 pi. This is again a standard value, omega is 4 pi. So phi e is equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught into 4 pi. Now, so we are substituting the value of the and we get the electric flux phi e as equal to q by epsilon naught. So that is equal to 1 by epsilon naught q. That is the statement of the Gauss law, which is the total electric flux in a closed surface, enclosed by a closed surface, is always equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed by that surface. So this is the thing. So it is phi e is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge. So for several charges, for example, here we have considered only one charge. If you consider number of charges in the closed surface, like plus 1, plus q1, plus q2 and so on, like minus q1 prime and minus q2 prime, minus q3 prime and so on, the total flux remains to be, because here inward flux is negative and outward flux is positive. And then, so the total flux is again the summation of the total flux. The total flux is phi e is equal to 1 by epsilon naught summation of all the charges. So q1, q2, q3, minus q1 prime, minus q2 prime, minus q3 prime. And the summation of all that gives you the summation symbol, sum of q. And if the case is for number of charges in a closed surface. Now see, this is the case when the charge is outside the surface. We have discussed the Gauss law for two cases. One, when the charge is inside the closed surface, and another is when the charge is outside the surface. I can take the same figure as that of the earlier one, but there occurs only two surfaces. One is inward and another is outward. In order to have a clear understanding that here there are two inward fluxes and two outward normal flux, so I have taken such type of figure. So we can do this for the figure earlier, which I have shown in the first case. But here, in order to have you a clear picture of the electric flux, to calculation of electric flux, I have shown like this. So here I am assuming a surface in this manner. So here the charge plus q is at point O. In the similar case as earlier the charge we assumed is inside this closed surface, but here the second case is the charge is outside the surface. So here the charge plus q is placed at point O in the figure C. So this point O, the it makes some it cuts the cone. Here a cone is being shown which is cutting this closed surface at four points A, B, C, D with elemental areas ds1, ds2, ds3 and ds4, right? So here this charge is placed outside and this d omega is the angle subtended at O due to these surfaces, due to these infinitesimal small surfaces ds1, ds2, ds3 and ds4. Now see, the electric flux at A through area ds1. See, what is the electric direction of the surface and the direction of field? Here the direction of the surface is opposite to the direction of the field, right? So here it is minus, hence that is minus. So the direction of the surface is ds1 is opposite to the direction of the electric field, so it is minus. So the flux over there is negative, so I write it as the electric flux in the previous topic, in the previous just now we have we learned that it is q by 4 pi epsilon naught d omega. If d omega is the solid angle, the electric flux due to charge q placed inside the closed surface, just now we have discussed it as q by 4 pi epsilon naught d omega. But now here the electric flux at point A through area ds1, the area ds1 is acting, the direction of ds1 is opposite to the direction of electric field, and hence here the negative sign occurs, right? Next, the electric flux at B through area ds2. See, ds2, it is inwards, outwards, sorry. So ds1, the electric flux is inwards, and here at point ds2, it is the area, elemental area ds2 is outwards, right? And the area direction as well as the intensity direction both are in the outward direction, right? So there it is plus q by 4 pi epsilon naught d omega. And next, the electric flux at C through area ds3. At point C, the small elemental area is ds3. There C, it is again the electric flux is inwards. If it is inwards, the elemental surface ds3 acts in the opposite direction that of the field E. Therefore, there negative sign occurs. So it is q minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught d omega. In the same way, the last elemental area ds4, it is outward, its direction is outwards, and it is in the direction of the field. Therefore, the electric flux is positive. So with all this, the total electric flux will naturally, you sum up all the flux through all the elemental areas, then you will get the electric flux to be zero. Hence, the electric flux over the whole surface due to an external charge is zero. So when the charge is placed inside, the electric flux is 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge, whereas when the charge is placed externally, that means outside the surface, whole surface, a closed surface, then the electric flux over the whole surface due to this external charge is found to be zero, which verifies the Gauss law, right? Thank you.